The final Vocaloid release of 2013 comes from iStyle Project and B-Platts, the companies which produced the Vocaloid Alculapis back in April 2012. While her voice bank was not too dissimilar from previous Vocaloids, Lapis's character concept certainly was. Most Vocaloids are described by fans as androids or cyborgs, and some official Vocaloid descriptions imply as much. Vocaloid itself is taken from the word android, so even though many Vocaloids lack descriptions at all, they are often considered by fans to be based on technology, whether it's contemporary or far into the future. Lapis, on the other hand, was the first Vocaloid specifically designed with a magical nature, as she is a fairy. She stands 15 centimeters tall, as a fairy she is invisible to most people, and her songs have the power to give life to those around her. Lapis became, and has remained, popular compared to the other original Vocaloid 3 releases, and this encouraged iStyle Project to quickly begin planning its second Vocaloid. That Vocaloid would be Merlie, who was released December 24, 2013, and she gives us our first confirmed Vocaloid family as she is Lapis's older sister. Like Lapis, Merlie was designed by the renowned artist Carnelian, and oh my goodness, we finally have a Vocaloid with some melanin in her skin. It has taken us 10 years, and it's about darn time. As you might imagine, Merlie is also a fairy. She stands 16 centimeters tall, one mere centimeter taller than Lapis, and her voice steals the life essence of those around her. That doesn't mean Merlie is evil, of course, that is simply the power of her magic. Merlie is said to be strong-minded and tsundere, but while she pretends to be a know-it-all, she is actually rather innocent and naive. I really enjoy Merlie's overall design, her color scheme, the fact that she wears shorts instead of a skirt, and the fairy element. It's different, and the magic angle in particular inspires different kinds of songs than the other Vocaloids often have. Merlie's name is taken from the stone Merlinite, which is not the name of a real mineral, but is a name trademarked by an American company which sells New Age healing stones and the like. Merlinite is a form of white chalcedony with black dendrite formations. So while the stone isn't really a kind of precious gem, it was chosen because it represents the complementary yet opposing nature of the sisters, as well as their dark and light color schemes. And while I'm on the subject, despite being sisters, Merlie is not Alki Merlie. Her name is simply Merlie. Again, like with Lapis, Merlie's voice provider was chosen from a contest. The way I believe the contest worked was that people were told to first pick a song that they felt fit Merlie's character, based on her design and description, and then upload a recording of themselves singing that song to Nico Nico. This took place in late 2012, and the videos are still there so you can listen to the submissions yourself, which means I can show off the submission from the winner of the contest, Miss Kamata Misaki. She actually submitted three different songs, singing in different tones for the contest, and I'll link to her submissions in the video description below. But I'll show off the submission that most closely matches Merlie's voice bank here.
この腕抱けるものなんてわずかだとわかってるけど。
Alki Lapis had a very light, sometimes breathy voice, and since Merlie represents Lapis's opposite, Merlie's developers chose a deeper sound for her. But while Miss Kamata provided a great voice to the Vocaloid, only a few official demo songs were released for Merlie. This is very disappointing, because demos do more than convince music producers to buy software, they get fans excited. And since Merlie is clearly a Vocaloid aimed at the fandom, she needed the opportunity to attract a larger fan base prior to her release. Instead, what the developers did was show off Merlie's songs and progress as her voice bank matured, so you can hear four versions of one of her demo songs, Justitia. The first was created when Merlie's voice bank was only 20% complete, one at 50% complete, a pre-release voice bank version, and then the final version. But even at 20%, the song still sounds very good. In fact, I had a difficult time telling much of a difference between this first version and the final version until I listened to certain parts of the song over and over again. but even if it's subtle, it is interesting to notice the smoother results. The 20% version sounds more like a Vocaloid 2 voice bank in comparison, as the syllables don't flow as smoothly as the final version. The earlier versions also lack any breathing notes because I believe they are the last sounds recorded for a voice bank. I was looking forward to Merlee ever since I first heard about her, and I'm worried that she isn't going to do very well because of the lack of demos and unfortunate timing, as Krypton Future Media's next big release was announced to be less than 2 months away from Merlee's release date. Still, Merlee was a fine way to end the year 2013, and her powerful voice has already won her many fans. With the ever-increasing number of multilingual Vocaloids, it may seem odd that companies continue to create single-language Japanese Vocaloids, but that simplicity helps keep costs down, as Merlee only sells for about $100, making her even less expensive than Lapis. She has an international retail package coming soon.
Let's go.
れて